Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate.
And my name is Will. Today we are going to show you guys the Vengeance 381L12-6
Touring Edition.
Super duper fancy smancy toy hauler. You guys, this thing is loaded with features. There's a lot to cover, so let's get started, okay? All right, now, Mate, what is the deal with touring versus all the other regular Vengeance?
So we looked at everything this fall, trying to figure out what is the high-end toy hauler fifth wheel, what's the best one to sell, what's the best one to buy, what's the best bang for your buck, and these guys, by far, have beaten everybody as far as look, as far as features, as far as construction, insulation, you name it. This guy has what you're looking for.
And really, when I first stepped into this floor plan, it has everything I think just about anybody could want. You have a large spacious bedroom. You have a big bathroom as well.
King bed, yep.
The king bed. Down in the dining area and the kitchen in particular, you have a ton of counter space. You have a double door refrigerator, large TV, plenty of seating. You have an extra bunk bed in the loft. Plus you got a 12.5-foot garage with an extra half bath in the back, not to mention all the additional sleeping back there.
And the back deck.
Patio system. I was gonna say, it just goes on and on. So let's stop doing the overview and let's see some of these features. All right, so here we are on the passenger side rear of the 381, and I wanna show you a few things over here. First off, this whole coach is vacuum bonded, so that's a way of making these fiberglass walls. It's 10 times less likely to delaminate than your typical pinch roll product, and a lot of times guys will vacuum bond the exterior walls, but they won't do the interior ones here, like on a slide out. This one, the interiors are vacuum bonded as well. Now down below, you see we do have it's a triple axle because this thing is so big. There are aluminum rims on each of the wheels, and that blue thing sitting in between the two wheels there, that's called an Equiflex suspension system. What is that? What that's designed to do is to help distribute the load evenly among the three axles, so all your weight is getting distributed evenly between the three. Now, over here, this right here is a port that you can hook up an extra Bose speaker that comes with this. So if you want this thing to be the party wagon, you can do that very easily. There's a plug-in right here for those as well. This unit comes equipped with 6-point auto level system, so you press a button and it levels itself out. We have a radius door with a friction hinge on it as well. And then we also have a 4-step entry into the garage. You'll see that there's Mate standing in there, and there's a screen door as well. Now we have the electric awnings, which Mate is pressing a button to show you. There's two, one on the passenger side and then the one that goes off the rear. Now the one off the rear is of course designed to help shade your patio deck, which we're gonna extend and show you here in a bit. But also just coming down this way too, you have frameless windows. You can see that on all of the exterior windows. This right here is part of a venting system for the garage. So as you drive down the road, you can kind of vent all the fumes out of there. And then down here, with our nice little sticker, you see this has a toy lock. So that's essentially a steel cable. It's locked in a reel right here with a lock on it. So if you need to chain up your toys or generator or whatever else you got, you can easily do that right here.
So over here on the front of the coach, I wanted to show you what one of these Bose speakers looks like. There's two of them, one for each side, and if you didn't feel like plugging in the super nice speakers, you do have a set of outside speakers that are mounted onside the coach right there on the slide out. These Bose speakers can also go in the garage, so if you want to mount them in there as well, you can do that too. Here you'll notice that we have this third awning. So this is another power awning that you can push a button on the inside and be able to make it go in and out with the LED light strip. And you have the amber light to be able to stop bugs from going in right by your door. And then through here you have your pass-through storage. So this is your 50 amp cord that comes with it. You do have TV connections if you decide to bring a TV out here. This is a foldable table that you can use outside. You can use it inside your garage, wherever you want. And then these are slam latch doors, so you can close them a lot easier than the compression type of doors. This right here is your solar plug. So if you decide to buy a portable solar panel, you can connect right into it. And then, you know, right now I'm sitting in the shade. It comes with a long enough cord that you can put it in the sun to be able to recharge your battery if you want. And then this compartment here is where you can put a couple batteries if you want and be able to make things happen. Here you have your Cummins Onan 5500 EVAP generator. This is tied in directly to your fuel tank, your 40 gallon fuel tank and your fuel station. So the benefit of that is you're only having to deal with one fuel tank instead of two smaller ones to kind of manage your fuel. And this guy runs a lot quieter than the 4,000 watt Cummins Onan generator, just because it's a bigger generator. It doesn't have to work as hard to get up to the correct amount of power that you're working on. This is where all your hydraulic lines are, and you'll notice that there's two little knobs up here. This means you can manually control your slide outs. So if you're parked on the side of a highway and you need to just put one slide out, the problem with hydraulic slide outs is normally that means all the slide outs have to come out. This one you don't have to do that because you have these controls right here. Two 30 pound propane tanks with the auto changeover regulator, so you're all set up in that area as well.
All right, now right here on the front, you guys have a full wraparound automotive painted front cap. So you have this nice automotive paint, a few decals on the front, and then you have down below some two blue LED strips right here just for some accent lighting for running lights. And then this is probably one of the most exciting things about the front of the area is the Trail Air pin box here. So this design, it's called the Rotoflex pin box. It's designed to, when you are going down a dip, let's say, a lot of times what you'll have is you'll have a little bit of a bend to this. This will go like this on your hitch, right? This is designed to flex with that. Because worst case scenario, let's say, if you went on a really, really steep dip and this thing had to pivot a lot, if it pivoted beyond the point your hitch is able to, you'll end up bending the bed of your truck. So this is designed to just make the ride easier, especially in those situations. Now, I want to take a minute and tell you guys the weight of this camper. So this thing dry with nothing in it weighs 14,272 pounds. Now your GVWR, your gross vehicle weight rating, now that's 19,500 pounds. So you have about 5,000 pounds of cargo. You probably won't put that much in this thing, but it's nice to know that it's beefy enough to hold all that weight if you need to. Now another nice feature you're gonna find right here is the auto level system. So right here, you press auto level, and this thing has a built-in gimbal. And what it'll do is it'll kind of lower itself down and then measure itself and level out, making little precise measurements until you're at 100% level, 100% level with the coach.
Yeah, that's super nice to be able to just, especially when you're on weird ground where it's crooked both front and back and side to side, it's nice to be able to push a button, walk away from it, and 15 minutes later, it's all level while you're putting all your stuff out and doing other things. Mm-hmm. Over here, this is your docking station. You'll notice that this does come with the high pressure coil hose here. This guy plugs right into this spot right up here. And you do have hot and cold water ran to this location. You also have a battery disconnect so that you can disconnect all the power to your coach if you need to. You also have your low point drains inside here. You also have all your dump valves, well, at least two of them inside here, where you can just unplug and plug back in. What that does is this has a fully enclosed and heated underbelly. So this is made for a little bit cooler weather if you need to. And that means your tanks are going to be, and especially your valves, are going to be protected when you need to not worry about freezing stuff.
Yeah, I mean, they even insulate this door here more. This is thicker than a standard door, just to give you a little bit of extra insulation in this area here.
This is also where you turn your cap lights on and off, and then you do have a little light right above here to be able to see what you're doing if you're in the middle of night. And you do also have a winterization port, which is kind of new too to this situation. What that is that makes it really easy to winterize your coach. You just switch this, and I like that they put this valve right here. Instead of having to unscrew something to be able to, it's usually a mess to try to winterize and de-winterize a coach. This makes the job a lot easier. Over here, you do have your hot water heater. This guy is a 10-gallon hot water heater, gas electric, so DSI, so that means you can get up to 16.2 gallons of water per hour heated up.
All right, you guys, now we gotta talk about your waste system here. It's not a pleasant thing to talk about, but it's very important when you're camping. Now, they equipped something on here called the Waste Master. So what this is just a built-in sewer hose system for you. Now, this end right here, this normally just stays connected to your dump port right here. And so once that's hooked up one time, you're done. You don't have to do it again. What that means for you is that this thing is super easy to dump. All you do is you open up this door here, you pull out this piece, you notice that there's a clear piece of plastic here. Now that's there so you can see once your water starts running clear and you know that you've emptied out all of your black tank. And then this simply plugs into place on the ground at the place where you're dumping at. You open up the valve and everything will rush on out. Or I should say this right here, this will open up what's inside the hose. When you're ready to open up the tank, you have a lever conveniently located right here that makes it really easy. So this is just gonna make things fast and simple.
Right here you have your fuel station fuel pump. So this connects into that 40-gallon fuel pump that I was telling you, or fuel station that I was talking about just earlier. And then you have your fuel pump gauge right here. So this will tell you how much fuel you have in your tank. And then this has an on-off switch. It's a 5-minute timer, so it'll automatically shut off so that you don't accidentally keep that fuel pump running all the time. You also have a collapsible ladder here. That's super important because if the ladder is not collapsible, then you're either one, not legal going down the road, or two, you have to store the stupid ladder inside the coach, taking up room that you needed for your toys. So to be able to get onto your roof is important because that means you can be able to brush stuff off the slide out before you ruin something. Onto the back deck here, the exciting part.
So before we get this thing put down for you, just a couple of things I want to show you real quick. You have right here a few springs to help assist you when you lower this thing down, because obviously this door is really big, but these springs lighten the way for you so you can easily lower it down. Up above you have again your electric awning that we were running out earlier. You have LED floodlights, and then directly above the door underneath the orange bug light is a little black piece. Now that's a dummy plug for a backup camera. If you want, this thing's already wired to provide power to a backup camera. You just take out the dummy plug, plug in the camera, sync it to a screen that you put inside of your coach, inside of your truck, and then you have a backup system ready to go. Now we're gonna unlock this in just a sec here, because these also are locked up right now. So you can lock this if you were gonna be storing this away from time. So we'll get this unlocked and show you how to set this thing down. All right, you guys, we're gonna show you how to set this thing up as a ramp first. So as you can see, it already has a couple steel cables that are holding it up right now. So all you gotta do to release it for the ramp is take out those pins. Those will drop down. And we're a little nose low right now, so this is a little more inclined than normal. Yeah. But then when you want to roll up your toys in here, you simply move these two pieces out of the way. Shoot, let's just show you real quick. There's a safety strap to undo. Well, those swing open and now you got full access to the garage.
Now that couch, you push a button basically, and that couch will raise up to the top of the deal so that you can pull through as you need to as well for your toys.
So now we'll show you how to set it up for the deck.
Oops, sorry.
There you go. I'll hold this in for you.
Got it.
Okay. There we are. Oh, and then Mate will jump up there.
So these things just roll across.
So you got these latches right here. You can see right here, there's a little caster wheel and you can easily just latch that right into place. Do the same thing with the other one.
And then
you also have, you can see here, Mate just latched up this door. So if you want to exit off this side, you can, you could park this thing over a lake, open up the door, dive right in if you wanted to. So we'll go inside now and, oh, wait, one more thing. Mate has a...
Yeah, I also wanted to show you guys it does have a screen, a bug screen. So if you wanted to hang out here and not have to worry about bugs getting inside your coach, you can do that too. So this has a deal. Goes all the way down if you need it to, and you're set. It's that easy.
So here we are on the back porch. Obviously our cameraman Octavio, he's way out there at the end. You can see that the awning is providing us with plenty of shade. Now let's move into the garage. We'll show you some features here. First thing I just want to mention real quick is you notice you have a nice dovetail in the garage. That's designed, of course, to make the angle up into this less severe, so you're not going to be bottoming out with your toys.
Yeah, another thing I really, and if you remember, we had that table that was in that pass-through storage. That table can fit right here if you want to be able to fit really six people around this table area. Or you can fit four with a couple cup holders on the side, so you can fold those away. Or if you want this to be a bed, you can fold these guys down and it makes into a large bed. Now you also are able to just push a button right here. This raises this guy up, and then you have this top bunk that can be raised down as well if you want to. I'll go ahead and show you what this looks like all the way up and then also down.
And you'll notice on each side of the couches here, you happen to have these blackout shades, so you can pop these down if you want to get ventilation and get more light. Right now, we'll just leave them there and let the chairs take them up.
This garage is 12'6", which is important to note because if you just have a 12-foot garage, which a lot of the competition does, that is just short of what you need to be able to fit your 12'4" razor inside here.
And I want to show you this too. So the D-rings are also equally important. Some guys will put on like 2,500 pound D-rings. Now these happen to be 5,000 pound D-rings. They're bolted right into the frame underneath of us here. Oh, there's the, you can see that you have, what, 9 D-rings throughout the entire garage. So you can strap down whatever you need to multiple different ways.
This ladder right here on the side, this can be either used as a bunk ladder if you want, or you can use it as a ladder to get into this loft area, which you access from the living room area.
Right.
There's 4 pins that I'm gonna go ahead and pull. The pins look like this, and they basically hold that top bed up. So we're gonna go ahead and pull all 4 of those pins.
We're gonna attempt to, assuming we're not short.
Pull that guy.
Hold on. You're gonna have to get that one. I can't reach it. Also, when this thing sets up in the bed position, you know you have a couple of legs right here. This is for when you're setting up as couches or a bed. But when you want to sleep on this, you have 2 extra supports for the top part of the couch here. And what that's gonna do, of course, is it's gonna make sure that these don't start bending down over time. So there we go, it's all set up. You can see here with the mattress, it's a huge sleeping area, and it's not a real thin mattress either. It's pretty thick given RV sizes. Also up above on the roof, or the ceiling I should say, You'll notice you have one AC. Now this coach comes equipped with three. There's a power management system because the way these campers work, even though they're 50 amp service, that allows you to run two ACs. So the power management system will help you determine which of the three you want running.
And you can run all three of those at the same time, and then the compressor just won't kick on.
Right.
It'll manage when those compressors do kick on. One other thing I wanted to show you with this bed system is these beds actually, if you have a very tall unit that you're having to pull in here with like a head rack, these guys can actually fold down to the side of the coach, giving you even more clearance to be able to fit your toys inside here.
All right, so we're still in the garage of the 381. I wanted to show you the half bathroom here. So you can see there's a lot of light, and that's because you happen to have a vent right above with a small fan as well. You do have lights in here too. You even have an outlet, sink of course. You have some storage with the medicine cabinet, access to the plumbing down below, and more storage down there. And then the most important thing that everybody, you have to make sure of when you're looking at a camper is, once I sit down on the throne, do I have enough leg room? And I can tell you, you got plenty.
Over here on the back side of the garage area, you do come with a Samsung TV and stereo system and amplifier. And this is where you can set those Bose speakers that I showed you hooked up on the outside. You can set them right here too if you want to have fancier speakers than just the TV speakers. This is where the speakers plug into. And then if you decide to do washer dryer, you do have hookups for that as well as diamond plate through here. This has the little circle, so if you get this wet, the water can be able to fit in between those circles, so it's not quite as slippery. And then look at the size of this door. This is a very wide door, and I like that you can be able to see into your garage from the living room, but yet you can still close it off if you're worried about fumes or whatever. And then over here are all your buttons. So this is for your awning to be able to retract, for the rear awning, side awning, bed lift controls, light switches. And I like that they're a little bit higher out of the way so little kids can't come mess with this unless they're at least this tall. And if that wasn't enough for the garage, check out all the storage above the garage. You also have the netting for if you want some helmets or something like that to be able to easy access. Notice that all the lights are LED and they're the nice high wattage Kelvin, so they're not like burning your eye type LEDs. And then garage speakers as well. So even if you have the Bose speakers put away and you didn't want to get them out, you also have the outside speakers, garage speakers, Bose speakers, living room speakers, you name it. Let's go check out the living room area. And we'll take it away.
So here we are right now in the living room. Let me show you guys the entertainment center first. So Vengeance is including a Blu-ray player. A lot of guys are just including a regular DVD player, but they do include a Blu-ray. Now this of course will play regular DVDs as well as Blu-ray. Down below we have an electric fireplace. Now that does kick out a good amount of heat for you. It'll make this room nice and toasty. Also of course has the lighting effect for you as well. And then the TV. So a large flat screen LED TV comes with the coach in addition to the sound bar as well. So that is all piped in here. And then storage above. There's storage just about everywhere you can think of. And then right above the garage, right above me right here, you'll notice there's also a secondary loft. There's even a plug and a cable outlet too. If you wanted to wire up a second TV there for kiddos, you can do that as well. The one last thing I wanted to show you too, and this, since we're in this area, is this little round circle here. So if I push on this, a little lid pops up, and I can pop up a little power station for you. So you have two USB ports, of course, two 110 outlets. And then if you're ready to drop this down, you don't need it anymore, press in the little red button and it's in place.
As you can see, I'm checking out the recliners over here. And the cool feature that they just recently added is the heated deal. So you can push a button and heat your seats while you're watching the movie. And that I like that the TV is in a good location, even in the living room area. Even if you have a couple extra people here, there's plenty of room that you can even watch it from the dinette if you want to as well.
So, and then of course here you have your dinette chairs and table. Right now this is extended out with a little extra piece here. You can fold that down however. And then you'll notice the windows. There's windows everywhere, and they have the nice roller shades so you can stop them wherever you'd like them to stop at, whether it's halfway or whatever the case is.
And then these guys are rain windows. So if you want to open up the windows and get some airflow, but you were worried about water getting inside here, you can open these guys up and still be okay.
Right, and the side ones also vent too. They're not rain windows though, they slide up. And the reason for that is right now we're in the slide out. So if you left a rain window open right here on the side, and you ran in your slide, it could crunch it pretty bad. So there's no risk of that.
They were actually
system.
Thinking.
They were thinking ahead of it. Of course, more LED lights up above, blue accent lighting. Where Mate's at right now in the kitchen, you'll notice he has his hands on the HiMac LG countertops.
So these are solid surface countertops, a lot easier to keep clean. You'll notice there's no T-molding involved to get junk caught into the edge there. And then this fridge is awesome. This is the gas electric refrigerator, but it's the 12 cubic foot. So this is probably the nicest refrigerator you can get in the RV market, as far as it's not just the electric side. Because what a lot of guys are doing is they'll put an electric fridge in here to save some money. The problem with that is, one, it can't handle nearly the stress that an RV fridge can. And if you're boondocking it and you're dry camping, that fridge isn't gonna work unless you're plugged into either a campsite power or you have your generator constantly running.
Mm-hmm. Now behind me is the sink setup. So they cut out of the countertops, two sink covers for you, so you have added kitchen space as well. Large, a farm basin sink, stainless steel. You got the high rise faucet as well. And then they put in this really nice tile backsplash on the unit too. That's a new feature this year. And there's storage everywhere. There's storage above us here, storage down below. You have large drawers and then access to underneath the sink. And then you have three more drawers on this side as well.
And that's not it for drawers. You also have six more drawers over on this side, as you can see. If you're wondering where all your remotes are, they're right here, guys. So you have remotes to everything. So if you want to be able to go outside, hang out by the campfire, and be able to bring your whatever remote, your radio remote, you have it. You do have the large 22-inch oven here. Another large pots and pans drawer below. More storage above here. And you have a normal size microwave instead of the tiny RV microwaves out there.
And then you also happen to have the nice light fixture above the kitchen as well. So you got the three chandelier lights, in addition to the LEDs, of course. And then directly above you, Mate, is one of the nicest features about it. It seems simple, but that fantastic fan moves a lot of
air. Yeah, so this is a max air fan with the rain sensor built into it. The nice thing about that is that fan will automatically open by just pushing a button on the side, and then if it starts to rain, it will sense that and automatically shut it for you, so you don't end up with a big puddle of water on the floor here.
So let's go check out the bathroom and bedroom, but before we do, I wanna show you guys a couple things right here. So down here is your breaker and fuse box. So if you had a fuse blow on you, there's a panel right here, and it'll actually light up to tell you which fuse is blown on you. And if you end up switching a breaker too, you can always flip them right there. Now directly below me too, on the stairs, you happen to have a little more storage. Again, they try to give you every inch that they can. And then up here, I want to show you guys a couple things. First is your control for your heat and your air conditioning right here. Now remember though, we did say this thing has three ACs. So this right here is your power control system. So this will allow you to run all three. It's just you won't have all three compressors running at the same time. It'll kind of pick and choose which ones to run when, or you can tell it to which ones you want running as well. Down here is a nice built-in Lippert screen. So this has manuals on board, and it can show you like how-tos, troubleshooting videos. There's your owner's manuals, they're right there, FAQs. It just goes on there. And then this is your control panel. So here we can check what level your batteries are at, what level your fresh black tank, gray tank, and galley tank are at. You can turn on your water pump, water heater, control all your lighting, control the slide outs, the awning, your tank heater, all of those things, and including start your generator as well. Well, come on into the bathroom, Mate, and show you what features that has.
Hey guys, so over here, you'll notice the sink is an upgraded type of sink here. Very nice additions there. You also have this, the medicine cabinet area right over here. LED lights again throughout the entire coach. Over here on the side, if you can see this, it does have the USB ports, which is kind of nice for a bathroom. GFI protected outlet. And then in the back side, if you needed a little bit more storage, there's like a little linen closet back here as well that you can see. In addition to all that, you do have a porcelain commode down here with a foot flush instead of a plastic one. And then this does have a seating area if you needed a seating area for your shower. Upgraded faucet right here, and then skylight above us so that you can get some natural light going in here as well.
Now here in the bedroom, there's a lot to go over. It comes with a TV already mounted, as you can see, in the bedroom as well. There's a solid door. It's not a sliding door. It's not a curtain, but it
feels solid too. It's like thick.
Yeah, it's not like a hollow door. So there's that as well. More storage right here for shoes, clothes, whatever. But actually for shoes, I want to show you this right here, a little cubby dedicated just for shoes. So that's a nice thing to have, because a lot of times everybody wants to know, where in the world can I put my shoes? Well, you can put them right there. Now this has a wardrobe slide. The slide control for that is right here. There's the button for it. And you can see there is a ton of storage in this thing. You got a lot. There's all this hanging space up above, and you have six drawers underneath for that, for storage down there as well. And then we have our bed right here. Now underneath this bed, there's more storage too. You just simply lift it up on the back end there, and you got all of that. It also comes, you can see, with a Denver mattress. It's not a no-name mattress company, so you know, you won't have a crooked back after you wake up in the morning. Also, of course, you have your third AC, which is right up here. Nightstands on each side with storage below, storage above. You have the two lanterns on each side, as well as an LED light up above, and a nice what do we call that? Headboard. So you could rest your back if you want to sit up at night too.
And the power setup on both sides. So you have USB and 110 outlets, both sides. And you have a super large window right beside us too, with the emergency exit and a rain window. So this side is the emergency exit. So this just pulls out if you need to. And then this side is the rain window, like I showed you just a second ago in the dining room area. So guys, that is the Vengeance Touring Edition, their highest level fifth wheel toy hauler that they have, the 381L12-6. Yeah, I think they need to make that name even longer.
I think there could be a W in there, possibly, you know. My name is Will, I'm the sales manager here.
My name is Mate.
He's the GM. And if you guys like this video, please let us know by hitting that like button for us. And if you know you want to see more videos on trailers, we do a lot of videos. So hit that subscribe button. You'll get alerted to every time we do new ones. We even do live videos as well. So if you're interested in kind of talking to us live, we've sat down, we've done that. We're just kind of getting that rolling. So we'd love to hear from you directly during a live presentation. And if you want to visit us and see photos of this unit or any other unit we have online, there's always our website. That's www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, and you can call us too at 970-313-4337, or you can email us at sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.
Also, we have financing. We do take trade-ins as well, so feel free to ask us any questions about that as well.
And if you guys would like to see a particular topic featured in one of our videos, please leave us a comment. Let us know. We would love to address some of the things you're curious about.
Thanks, guys.